In the name of Allah, God most gracious, most merciful. Dear viewers, peace be unto you all. All praise to Allah, the sustainer and cherisher of the whole world. Today, December the 2nd, 2015, episode number 198. Under the title of Cursed. Here, this verse, we forgot to mention it, you know, it's one of the kind of people mentioning, one of the kind of people that Allah didn't like them. So, we can read this in Arabic and read it in English. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا جرم أن الله يعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون ولا يحب المستكبرين. Here the ayah is telling us that Allah doesn't like the arrogant. I'm gonna read the verse 2-2. Now we are reading actually from Chapter 16, I'll start with the verse 22 and with the 23. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إلهكم إله واحد فالذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة قلوبهم منكرة وهم مستكبرون لا جرم أن الله يعلم ما يسرون وما يعلون إنه لا يحب المستكبرين. Our God is one God. Okay. It says here, your God is one God as to those who believe not in the hereafter, their hearts refuse to know and they are arrogant. Undoubtedly, Allah does know what they conceal and what they reveal. Verily, he loved not the arrogant. Well, this is very, very important subject. And this is the sickness that drove the devil out of the garden, out of paradise, of the heaven. Because he was very arrogant person, and when Allah asked him to prostrate before him, says, look, I am better than Adam. So the arrogance, his the ego that he has drove him and from the prison of Allah. Now we have this kind of arrogance all over, with the percentages of course, because how many the arrogance and the cocksureness, something like this, is the one who forbid us from accepting the truth. When the Holy Prophet said to the companion, one small jot from arrogance, if anybody has it, he will not be able to go to heaven. So the disciples were very terrified and they are frightened. And they asked the Holy Prophet, they said, the man of us, one of us, all of us, we like to shape up and good, have a good dress, and, you know, have a shaving, something, be a good appearance. Is this arrogant? He said, no, this is not arrogance. This is really good, but arrogant is two things. If you mock people, look down to people, and you reject the truth. If you do this, this is the arrogant. Because if you do this, you actually make very big block between you and the truth. So how can you go to heaven? If somebody tells you, okay, God is one and one God. And he says, no, he's three in one and three. You see, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, these three are one. First of all, when you see these three are one God. So we want to know what the name of that God. No one knows. Well, if you have to do this, at least you can say in the name of Allah, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And still it's not working right. It's still the polytheism. But anyhow, so organs. If you take the some nations as a whole, they are rejecting the truth, and they want to run their life by their own desire, their own say, and they want to not to listen to the truth. So you find they didn't obey Allah, they didn't obey their parents or the truth, so they go straight. And the devil will drive them, keep driving them out of the truth. So arrogance is very, very bad act, and it's really dangerous sickness. You know, you see it very, very clearly here in this country which we live in. This country, they have very bad rulers, and they're brought them to the worst situation can ever be. And people get the sickness, the arrogance, when you stop by traffic lights and you see people swallowing their cheek, and then they are arrogant, they didn't look to you. If you say, peace be unto you, they will astonish and they will say, what do you need? Do you know me before? Well, actually they are not Muslims, you know, they are Sunni, by the way. So, and their swindle, if they want, they can swindle all the, to take your properties. Properties, and they are cheating. So, because they do not allow the truth to come to their hearts, so they become like this. We are looking for that time. We work for that time when we become free. And we can free people also, because that somebody drove them actually to this situation through the years passing by, since we have this bad regime here, which is the worst one in the whole world by all means. So again and again, should watch ourselves from that sickness, because if you do have it, we will end up in the very bad shape, and end up, of course, to go to hellfire. And then Allah does not like us, first instance. So I hope that we take this very serious. Till I see you later in time, I leave you with this good greeting of Allah. Peace be unto you all.